This is high school basketball on Frontier Community Access Television.
Warrior into Diaz. Lays it up and in. Warrior, jump shot is good.
Boy.
Hook shot goes.
The left side of Diamond. Diamond spots up to
three and hits it.
Now it's back to Diaz.
Shot good.
Diamond gets the lane, lays it up off the glass and in.
Junior runs the baseline, reverse layup goes. Hook shot off the glass and in.
This is high school basketball on Frontier Community Access
Very aggressive. Skyhook. Diaz. Hook shot. The lane is good. Warrior drives through, running. One hander off the glass and in. Dean. 3-point lane. She gets it. Dean. Elephant three. Good.
This is high school basketball in Bear Country 95.3. Tonight's game. The Mahar Senators and the Frontier Lady Redhawks. This is Chris Collins. Bobby C is alongside tonight as we start to wind down the regular season. The Mahar Senators come to South Deerfield to take on the Frontier Redhawks, a battle of 1 and 2 in the Franklin County North Division. Bob, should be an interesting contest.
Well, you know, one thing that I have noticed from the beginning of the year to now is that of all the schools in our area, the Frontier Lady Redhawks have definitely been the most improved, which is a really good sign for them. So they're in really good shape right now, being able to keep building their program. But as we know, Chris, this team from Mahar has a lot of good weapons, and they have been solid all season long, and they are undefeated right now in the league play.
6-0 in the league, 13-5 for the regular season. They're on the way to the tournament. The good news is, so are the Frontier Redhawks, by virtue of locking up second place in the division. So no matter what happens tonight or tomorrow night against Ware, Frontier is in the playoffs. They'll be in the first round, likely on the road. But still, a tremendous thing under a first-year coach to be able to clinch a playoff spot is a great thing.
Well, you know, when you got a guy like Marty Sanderson, a guy who's definitely had a great track record with being able to put some great boys basketball teams together, he comes in, fills the void that they need, and watches his team improve, that's got to be a good feeling not only for him, but also for the fans here in South Deerfield tonight.
Absolutely, and the Frontier boys, I'm pretty sure, are not going to be on at the postseason, but this girls program, as you mentioned, much improved. They get a lot of balanced scoring, but the three-point threat on this team is Ella Dean. She likes to shoot from the outside.
She sure does, and she has a nice ball, too. You know, I've been following these ladies throughout the season because of a special show that I do every week. And the one thing I could tell you is watch out for Diaz, because she's not so bad herself. You know, Sobieski's done a great job. Ella's done a great job. It's just a good team effort right now. Seeing five or six different scorers in the score box makes it nice, too, Chris. So hopefully they're going to be able to play some good defense and contain this fast-paced game that Mahar likes to play.
Frontier will be without Tori Speth, one of their better bench players. She is out with an arm injury. And for the Mahar Senators, 13-5 says it all, 6-0 in the league. But they've got all kinds of great players. Katie Gilson, Hannah Paul, Samantha Rowe, Kersey Verhaen, a lot of names that have been around this program for a long time. They should probably make a deep run in the playoffs, I would think.
Yeah, and I think that too. I've been very impressed with this team. I've had a chance to watch them a couple of times and really like their ball play. They do have good shooting too, and that's the big key right there. They put a lot of points on the board.
We'll take a 2-minute break, come back, starting lineups, national anthem, and the opening of this one, Mahar at Frontier on Bear Country 95.3.
Thanks, Jane. Our guests this evening are the Senators from Mahar Regional High School. The member high schools of the MIAA cordially welcome you to this game. The students participating in tonight's contest are representing their schools, their families, and themselves. Please encourage these student athletes with your personal display of support and good sportsmanship. Now, for tonight's starting lineups. First, for Mahar, at forward, number 3, Kiana Riley. At forward, number 33, Meg Powell. At center, number 31, Cassie Verhaen. At guard, number 4, Kenzie Tenney. And at guard, number 10, Hannah Paul. Mahar is coached by Larry Fisher. And now for Frontier, at forward, number 4, Lisa Fournier. At forward, number 1, Marie Demon. At center, number 2, Helena Diaz. head guard, number 23, Ella Dean. And their guard, number 3, Ariana Walker. And here is coached by Marty Sanderson. The officials for tonight's game are John Patava and Don Hodgkins. Would you please rise for the playing of our national anthem?
We're set to go here. This is one of those games, Bob, that, you know, Mahar comes in with not a lot to lose. Neither team does. I mean, they're both going to the postseason, but this would be great, a great booster going into the postseason for Frontier to get this win. And also, it would help probably with their seeding hopes, because the better record you are, the higher you're going to go. It's no other way around it.
Yeah, but don't think that this would be a nice little boost for them to be able to go into tournament play coming up soon here with a big win over a good team. That would be something very special for them. But as we know, this Mahar team has some experience. They have a good ball club, and boy, they are big. They really are.
They have a lot of height, a lot of scoring ability. The total package. We will see what happens.
Yes, and they do a really nice job moving up and down the court, too. So the Redhawks are definitely going to have to stay with this team throughout the night.
Portier will jump. Center for Frontier against Kiana Riley from Mahar. Tip is controlled by the Redhawks. They move left to right. Right side to Walker. Walker bounce, has the Diaz in the paint. Shut off, back out to Walker. Ella Dean, top of the key now with the ball. Always a three-point threat. Throws it left side to Diamond. Diamond feeds Portier in the lane. Portier tries to go through, off the glass and in.
Nice move right there by Lisa Portier.
2-0. Mahar now with the basketball. Running right to left. This is Paul. Left side to Riley. Riley down low to Powell. Put up shot partially blocked. Battle for it. Tie up. Loose ball. Possession arrow favors Mahar.
Chris, I'm going with the over on jump balls tonight.
Yeah. You're probably right there. Kiana Riley, inbound to the baseline, off the glass, and a foul as going up for the shot was Maeve Powell, and she'll get two here.
That was a really good look right there. Nice job getting the ball inside.
Powell's first shot upcoming is good. Tonight's game being brought to you in part by KBR Designed, South Deerfield Polish American Club, Karis Oil, and Matusco Trailer Repair. Second shot is good. She makes them both, and we're tied at 2. Frontier with the basketball now. Dean bringing up the floor, running the point for the Redhawks. Right side to Walker. Ariana, top of the key to Diamond, over to Ella. On the left elbow, Ella. And she gets bumped on the way through, and it's going to be a foul, and they're going to get, I believe, Hannah Paul on that one.
And they are.
Non-shooting, inbound under the basket. First team foul from Mahar, first for Paul. Marie Diamond to throw it in. And she does. Out to Ella. Ella right side to Diamond. Diamond drives the baseline, tries to feed Diaz, goes through her hands, and Mahar will take it back the other way. Paul tries to thread the needle on the baseline to Tenney, and it's still going to be Mahar's basketball with 24 to shoot.
That was a good look right there. Just wasn't able to hold on to the ball. Good defense right there by the Redhawks.
Riley to throw it in. And she does to Tenney. Now back over in the corner. Paul for 3. No good. Tenney the rebound. Kicks it back out to Powell. Powell drives through, running one-hander in the lane is good.
Nice move right there by Maeve Powell.
Little lefty. Actually, that was Cassie Verhang. Excuse me, not Maeve Powell. Verhang with a nice little left-handed bunny. And now Walker. Top of the key to Diamond. Diamond left side to Dean. Dean driving through, pull-up jumper blocked in the lane. And rebound pulled down by Riley. Riley right side to Tenney. Tenney drives through, collides with the Frontier player. Put back by Verhane is no good. And Verhane gets the rebound again and gets fouled, trying to cut around Diaz. And Marty Sanderson wants to talk about it. Who could blame him? Timeout on the floor. We will take the break. 6:07 to go in the first quarter on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. It's Mahar 2, or Mahar 4, rather. Frontier 2. This is high school basketball on Bear Country 95.3. Thank you. So quick timeout by Marty Sanderson. Did not like what he was seeing in terms of the rebounding, I don't think, by his team. I mean, Mahar had three or four rebounds in that exchange there.
Well, you know, that's the one of the most frustrating things for a coach is when you go down to the end of the court and you only get one and dones and the other team is getting three or four opportunities. It's tough to win a game when they get that many extra chances that you don't.
Kenna Riley to inbound for the Senators, who lead 4-2. And Riley throws it in to Tenney in the middle of the lane. He just fired it up.
Nice. Yeah, that was a nice look, huh? Nice inside pass, nice and easy. Good job by Kenzie Tenney.
Walker now runs right side over to Portier. Portier tries to drive the baseline. It's blocked by Verhaen. Frontier retains, though. Ella Dean tries to run through, gets blocked on the way through. Boy, two or three blocks like that, and Verhaen is unbelievable. Cassie runs it up, tries to feed the paint. Goes through everybody, but Mahar is able to hang on to it. Now Hannah Paul hands off to Riley for three. Spins out, no good. Paul, the rebound. No rebounding right now for Frontier. Riley in the middle. Verhaen fires through the lane. Shot up, no good. Rebound pulled down by Frontier. This is Diamond. Marie. And a little hand check foul as she tried to break down the baseline.
Looks like they're going to get Maeve Powell on that one.
Second team foul on Mahar. And the first on Powell. Diamond inbound. Frontier looking for someone to pass. She tries to get to Diaz, but it ends up in the hands of Walker. Walker to Diamond. Diamond over to Walker. Ella Dean now has the top of the key. Ella in three-point land goes left side to Portier. Portier to Diamond. Diamond shut off. Portier now tries to drive through. Tries to go in Verhaen. That's, her third block in this quarter.
Boy, she goes up and down the court, too.
She airmailed the pass too far ahead, so Frontier will get it back. So a break for the Redhawks, but no solving. And that's really that drive on the baseline is a big part of Frontier's offense. And they've taken it away from them big time in this
quarter. Oh, yeah.
Quarter.
I mean, they're blocking every shot, Chris. They're not even getting a decent look.
Ella Dean now. Bounce pass on the right wing to Portier. Portier tries to drive a few. Bounces it to Diaz. Lays it up. No good. Best look Frontier's had so far at the basket.
I agree. That was a great look right there. Too bad that Diaz couldn't finish.
Right side to Paul. Now a three ball. Line drive by Riley is no good, but rebound pulled down by Victoria Tenney just into the game. And high post. Ball is hit on the floor. Still alive, though, and Frontier is able to keep it, but only temporarily. Now it's out of bounds. So kind of a weird exchange there, but it'll go back the other way.
Well, you know what happened was is they didn't wait for they thought that they were going to blow the whistle, and the ref said, hey, we're going to play. Let's do it.
Abby Bonk into the game for the Mahar Senators. Seeing her first minutes. Ella Dean now has the ball, top of the key to Diamond. Diamond tries to drive right side, shut off to Portier. Portier drives the baseline, running one-hander over everything. Rebound pulled down by Bonk on the far side. Outlet pass looking for Tenney down court. Out of bounds, and it's still going to be Mahar basketball.
Boy, things are getting a little sloppy right now, Chris. Both ends of the court here. I think that Mahar needs to sort of set up something. They're almost going too fast, Chris.
I think you're right. I think they're a step ahead of themselves. Three-point field goal from the right elbow is no good. Rebound pulled down by Portier. And handed off for Marie Diamond. Diamond tries to spin through, draws double coverage out to Dean. Dean, jumper from the baseline is good.
Nice shot right there. Ella Dean.
They needed that bucket badly. That breaks a long drought for Mahar, or for Frontier, rather. Now Bonk. Left side to Tenney. Tenney's jumper from the baseline is no good. Out of bounds. Stay with Mahar. Last touch by a Frontier Redhawk.
Well, even though you're getting out rebounded 2-1, or maybe even 3-1, you're still only down by a bucket. So the defense, at least for Frontier, at least being able to get in the faces of Mahar, have been okay. It's just being able to pull down those bounds, Chris.
Sarah Munier into the game for the Redhawks. Inbound pass on the baseline to Maeve Powell. Up and good. Gee, that was Verhaen again. I keep getting those two mixed up.
She's 31. Powell's 33.
D
Dean now, right side to Portier. Portier, bounce pass in the lane. Alexa Boyden just into the game. Shot up is no good. And now this Red Hawks trying to get some things working here. Hickey now with the ball traveled.
Yep, that was a good call right there. Definitely Kate Hickey dragged her foot.
So Hickey's into the game now, and Alexa Boyden has just checked in as well. Abby Bonk now, left side to Tenney. Back to Bonk. They're throwing it around. Tenney, a three-pointer. Side of the iron, no good. Put back is no good. Another shot, that's no good. Third, fourth, how many shots are they going to get at it? And they finally score. Unbelievable.
Wow, Kenzie Tenney with three rebounds in a row.
Would not be denied. And there's some debris on the floor, so they had to get rid of that. Or actually, something fell off of one of the players. So we'll start again. But you cannot let them have five shots at the ball, at the bucket, Bob. You just can't.
I'm going to take a guess and say one of their hair ties.
So I don't know what the Patala is going to put some time back on the clock here, I think.
Probably 9 seconds, so I bet you might go to
the shot clock reads 10. I don't know how that is.
They're going to 220. Yeah, they're going to have to change that.
The shot clock has to change. Now they put 28 seconds on the shot clock.
Yeah, there you go.
Now we're set. Ella Dean brings it up for Frontier. Dean drives through, pull up, pop in the lane. She gets fouled on the way up. And she will get a couple of shots.
Did they end up getting Bonk on that one?
I don't know. We'll see what they post.
From the rear side? Because she might have been. Yep.
Yep. It's first one on Abby, three on the team. It's a 10-4 Mahar lead. 2:12 to go in the first quarter. And Ella Dean at the line for a couple of foul shots. Her first shot is no good.
Wow, that looked perfect, too.
Tonight's game being brought to you by Smith Keller Funeral Home and by Galinsky Landscaping and Wisdom Way Self-Storage. Ella Dean's second shot. That one goes. Makes one of two. The lead is cut to five. 10-5 Mahar. And here come the Senators. Paul in the middle to Tenney. Tenney to Paul. Through her hands, and Lisa Portier comes over. Nice hustle play to steal that ball back.
All right, this is a big spot right here for Frontier. If they can be able to pull off a nice two or a three here, they're right back in this thing.
Portier driving through, got blocked by Verhaen. Kind of a crazy shot, and Mahar comes back the other way. Now driving through is Jasmine Vitor. Shot is no good.
Oh, that was a nice box out right there.
Rebound pulled down by Frontier. This is Dean. Right side to Portier. Portier goes back out to Hickey, over to Dean. Left side, Dean. Trying to drive through off the glass. Shot up, no good. Nice look, though, on the baseline. And it's going to be off Frontier. We're going the other way.
Well, I'll tell you right now, if Frontier can be able to fix that one minor adjustment on defense, which is to pull down the rebound and not give second or third chances to Mahar, this is going to be an interesting game here tonight.
Yeah. 10-5, 1:12 to go in the quarter. Low scoring first quarter on both sides of the ball. Now a pass inside, turnaround jumper by Vitor is no good. And Frontier with the rebound. Walker now over to Dean. Right side to Walker. Walker drives the baseline, gets a screen, bounce pass in the lane, gets it back out. Pinpoint passing by Frontier right now. Ella Dean spins it around, gets back out to Walker, top of the key. Now Portier has it right side. Portier feeds Boyden in the lane. Boyden's put up shot. She got fouled by Verhaen on the way up. And Lexa will go to the line.
That was great ball movement right there by Frontier, trying to find that open look. They found the open person, and now they get rewarded for it.
Well, best exchange passing-wise of the night for the Frontier Redhawks. And Lexa will shoot, too. First one's good. She'll get one more.
That's the old saying, the old nothing but nylon.
Hickey out, Diamond back in for Frontier. And Lex's second shot is good.
Same thing. Yeah, nothing but nylon on both.
10-7, 40 seconds to go
in the first quarter. Right side to Vitor. Back to Paul. Paul gets back. And he tried to feed the paint.
Whoa!
As Vitor got hung up, and wow, that's going to look great on TV. That was almost like a wrestling move.
And honestly, you know what that was? That was Marie Diamond doing her Superman impersonation on that one.
It was pretty odd looking, but she had instant replay on that one.
Well, glad that she's okay.
She got up slow, but she's good. Diamond now on the right elbow with it. Diamond fakes the shot. Gets it back over to Walker, to Dean. Left side, 17-second shot clock is off. Dean tries to drive through, gets poked. And Hannah Paul comes away with it from Mahar. Paul tries to go up and draws a foul on Marie Diamond. So Hannah Paul to shoot two. 9.7 seconds left to go in the first period. First shot does not go. She'll get one more. Verhaen back in. Mackenzie Tenney is out. Also back into the game is Portier for the, Kate Hickey for the Frontier Redhawks. Paul's second shot is good. Makes 1-2. That makes it a 4-point lead, 11-7. 9.7 seconds left in the first quarter. Dean runs it right side. Dean goes cross court. Dean with 3 seconds on the shot clock. Three ball.
Good. Nothing but net. What a great shot to end the quarter.
And that is how the first quarter will end. At the end of one quarter of play from Goodnow Gymnasium in South Deerfield, it's the Mahar Senators 11, Frontier Redhawks 10. This is high school basketball in Bear Country 95.3. Interesting first quarter as we're going to start the second here with the Mahar Senators, who led by as much as six, leading by only a point after that three-pointer by Ella Dean at the buzzer.
Well, you know, Ella Dean's had a tough time tonight. She had three of them that were rejected earlier in the game, but to come up with that big three right there to sort of get the boost going for the Redhawks was nice. Now they got to play some defense, and they got to continue to attack the ball, which they've been able to do, but they got to get those rebounds. Don't give Mahar second or third chances because this team's too good for that.
Yeah, that's one area where Mahar has really been head and shoulders literally above Frontier, but you know, if they can start shooting from the outside, Frontier could do some damage. They got a couple of three-point shooters that could really stick it. Uh-huh. Anna Paul now gets the inbound pass to start the second quarter, right side to Tenney. Tenney tries to feed down low to Powell, and it's stolen back by Frontier again. Good D by the Redhawks. Ball lobbed ahead to Portier. Lisa draws double coverage. Back out to Walker, over to Dean. Dean gets a screen from Diaz. Back to Portier, top of the key. Portier right side to Walker. Walker down low to Boyden. Back out to Walker, top of the key to Dean. 8 seconds to shoot. They feed Lexa Boyden in the paint. Shot up is no good. Battle for the rebound. And Diaz comes away with it. Put back. Shot is good.
Wow, what a play right there by Diaz.
And just like that, Frontier has the lead back, 12-11. They feed the paint to Powell. Shot is no good. Put back is no good, but a foul over the back, and we'll see who they get. This is going to be Maeve Powell. This is the first foul on Lexa Boyden, team's fourth. Powell. First shot is no good. Tonight's game being brought to you by Greenfield Savings Bank and by the International Association Brotherhood of Hampshire Franklin Officials. The All-Star game coming up on St. Patrick's Day. Second shot spins out, no good.
Oh, man, that was right in there, too. Came right out.
Dean now bounces ahead to Portier. Portier runs the right side, gets a lane, stops, cuts, goes back to Ella Dean. Left side to Ariana Walker. Walker down low to Diaz. Diaz drives through, a hook shot in the lane, doesn't go. And battle for the rebound, controlled by Mahar. Here comes Tenney. In the middle, driving through is Verhaen. Hook shot in the lane, no good. Verhaen gets her own rebound and loses control, stripped, and Frontier takes it back.
Great D right there by the Redhawks. They've done a nice job the last couple of possessions.
Trying to feed Diaz down low, kick, and there'll be a reset on the shot clock. Well, you can see Verhaen frustrated. She thought she got fouled on the way up in the second shot, but no call. Dean, bounce pass right side to Portier. Portier draws double coverage, not a big surprise there. She's been well scouted. Left side it goes to Walker.
Back to Dean, top of the key. Dean's just going to take the three ball. Doesn't go. Diaz the rebound. Put back blocked. And Frontier, though, is able to get it back. Dean spots up again for three and hits the side of the iron. No good. Powell battles for the rebound with Diaz. Held ball. Possession arrow stays with Frontier.
You know, they are working hard. One thing I could say about Frontier is right now, they're really starting to step up their game.
Well, it's a whole different game when they have Diaz out there because they've got some actual rebounding support, which they didn't have for quite a big part of that first quarter because she was out with fouls. Ball lobbed out deep to Walker. Walker right side to Portier. Portier wanted the three, didn't take it. Bounces it back to Walker. Walker over to Dean. Dean for three. Good!
Another big shot right there by Ella Dean. Hey, listen. She's a good shooter. She has a nice outside shot. You got an open look like that, you got to take it.
And just like that, Frontier's up by four, 15-11. Paul now runs right side, shot off by Dean. Verhaen for three, no good. Portier the rebound. Lisa runs it up. Portier goes up strong, count it in one.
Oh, what a way to attack the basket. Great job right there by Lisa Porter. She really did a great job right there. That was a nice move.
Well, she is definitely one of the leaders of this team, and that time she finally got a look on the baseline that was halfway decent, and she made every bit of it. Chance for a three-point play to make this a seven-point lead. Does not go. Diaz gets the rebound, though. Goes for the putback, no good. Boyden goes up. She gets fouled on the way up, so much more aggressive Frontier on the boards.
Yeah, they've really stepped it up. Really stepped it up. I don't know what Coach Marty Sanderson said in that big powwow they had, but whatever it did, whatever he said was good because it's working.
Probably said dig in. And by the way, that's two fouls on Cassie Verhaen for Mahar, and they could ill afford to get her in foul trouble. Boyden's first shot in front of the iron, no good, and they're going to get Verhaen out of there, I think. Oh, no, they're going to get Powell out of there. Verhaen stays on the floor.
I think they gave the foul to the wrong person, I thought, but I'm not sure, Chris. We'll have to see. Well,
Verhaen and Powell are both on the bench right now.
Mm-hmm.
Boyden's second shot. And that is no good. Battle for the rebound, out of bounds, and it's going to stay with Frontier as it went off of a hard player.
Wow, well, hey, you know, now you come up with a nice play. Now you might stack things up a little bit, Chris. Try to get that open look down low and see if you can get the easy bucket.
I think if Frontier scores here, Mahar's going to want to take a timeout and stop this because this has been all Red Hawks for about 2 or 3 minutes here.
Yeah, I'm surprised that Coach Fisher hasn't tried to calm his ladies down because they had a six-point lead at one time, and now they're down by six. We're talking a 12-point swing.
Yeah, unusual. No, they're going to talk to Marty. I'm not sure what's going on. Perhaps there's some... Is there a problem on the floor? They got site manager, Mr. Osborne, is out there. That usually indicates there's a problem with the playing surface, but I'm not sure what's going on, but we are ready to go. Portier to inbound. Portier inbounds to Dean. Over to Walker, to Portier. Now Boyden on the high post feeds Diaz in the paint. She draws a foul.
Boy, they're doing a great job attacking the basket. And by attacking the basket the way they are, Chris, they're forcing right now Mahar to commit a lot of fouls, and now they're in the 1-1.
Not only that, but ball possession. I mean, they've had control of the basketball for a good stretch here. Elena Diaz. First shot is good. She'll get one more. That makes the lead 7. And if she hits this one, it'll be the largest lead of the ball game for either team. Yeah, second shot. Does not go. Rebound pulled down by Mahar. This is Vitor bringing it up. Vitor right side to Paul. Back to Vitor, top of the key. Vitor feeds the paint to Tenney. Back to Vitor. Now a three-pointer from the corner by Riley is no good. And Boyden comes down with the rebound.
Boy, Mahar's gone ice cold right now from outside shooting, and they're just not being able to get anything to go down.
Portier now to Dean, top of the key. Ella looking for someone, and she's just going to take the three because they gave it to her. No good. And rebound put back by Portier is no good. So right now, Frontier is winning the battle on the boards, much better than they were, obviously, earlier.
Absolutely. Boy, Lisa Portier had a beautiful shot right there. That was an easy deuce that they missed.
Now Paul gets the inbound pass. Paul goes right side, gets it back from Tenney. In the corner to Riley. Back to Paul, top of the key to Tenney, right side. Tenney tries to feed the lane out of bounds off of Frontier. Mahar will keep it with 15 seconds to shoot.
Well, great job right there by the ladies. I'll tell you, very impressed with the way Frontier's playing right now. They've really shut down Mahar.
Olivia Dean is into the game. Shot put up, blocked. Now battle for it, tied up, and it's still going to be a Mahar basketball in the tie-up as Ella Dean went in there trying to tie up Victoria Tenney, or excuse me, Jasmine Vitor.
Well, they're bringing in their best player right now, as far as I'm concerned tonight anyway. She's definitely been on fire. I think Cassie Verheyen has done an awesome job, and they need her back in here.
Verheyen gets the shot off the inbound pass. No good. Portier the rebound. And Lisa dribbles out of trouble. Over to Ella. Dean now drawing some backcourt pressure. Drives up the left side on the left elbow. Comes cross court. Ella looking for someone to pass to. Tied up, out of bounds. Mahar basketball. They just hemmed her in really well.
That was a great defensive set right there by Mahar. That was well needed, too. They need to come up with a bucket here. They got to get some kind of a momentum going on offense.
Well, they haven't scored any. They haven't scored for an entire half of a quarter here, which is unheard of.
That is correct.
From a team like this, with this kind of offensive power. And now a foul on Tenney, who was shooting a three.
And Diaz is going to get ticketed on that, and it's going to be three shots.
Yeah.
Oh, she was inside the line. Okay.
That's the second foul on Elena, too, so that pair's watching.
All right, so she is only going to get two.
I thought it was a three-pointer, too, but back Tenney apparently was taking a two. First one is good. Tonight's game being brought to you by Muffins General Market and the Sandry Companies. Not to mention Helena Chemical, the sponsor of the Helena Chemical Company Player of the Game. Second shot by Mac Tenney is no good. Spins out. Put back by Vitoro is no good, and she gets two shots.
Yeah, nice job right there. See how those offensive rebounds can be so effective for you? That's exactly why they're back at the line. Nice job on the offensive rebound.
Well, it looked like Mahar backed off a little bit, and that's one of the reasons why they've been having problems, I think, putting the ball in. First shot does not go.
Yeah, boy, they've gone really cold right now.
Mahar's
really cold.
1 point in 4 minutes and 7 seconds of the second quarter. That's unheard of for a team that's 6-0 in the league.
And they're normally scoring a lot more points than this, and this is really surprising.
I'm not sure. I think that maybe there's a concern about her shot delivery. We'll see. Let's see what happens here. Vitor now. Second shot does not go. Misses them both. Ball still alive, though. Rebound Tenney, and she gets fouled.
Wow. And what did they get? An offensive foul?
It was an offensive foul. I think they cleared with the elbow.
Yeah, she did clear with the elbow.
So going back the other way, it's going to be two on Mackenzie Tenney. As right now, Mahar is putting a little pressure on in the backcourt. And they're going to run both the Deans out of a stack here. And Ella will get the inbound pass. Back over to Portier, over to Olivia. Olivia up ahead to Boyden. So they break the press. Boyden hands it back to Olivia Dean. To Ella, top of the key. Ella bounce pass left side to Portier. Portier to Olivia. Olivia spots up for three. No good.
Good luck.
Boyden the rebound, though. Ella put back off the glass, too strong. Portier got the rebound. So three rebounds there by Frontier, and Portier gets fouled.
Well, you know, what happened to them in the first quarter, they're starting to be able to take advantage of those offensive rebounds here in the second quarter, Chris. And that is on, I'll tell you right now, that's a big foul right there on Kenzie Tenney, because she is a big part of this team. And for her to have three fouls, that's tough.
Especially when you put 1 point on the board in the entire quarter. First shot by Portier is no good. She'll get one more.
Starting Tenney to miss the free throws now, too, Chris.
Tenney's going to sit down, and Olivia Dean checks back in. Maeve Powell, checks back in for Mahar. Portier's second shot, front of the iron, no good. Rebound controlled by the Senators. Anna Paul runs it up right side. Paul loses control. Olivia Dean picked her pocket. Up ahead to Portier. Portier, breakaway layup, too strong. Battle for the rebound. Second put back by Frontier is no good. Portier gets the rebound, puts it back up, no good. Portier's still battling. out of bounds, and it's going to stay with the Redhawks.
Boy, they're working really hard. Boy, that was another nice, easy bucket for Lisa Portier. She had that. Another easy deuce, and she missed it again.
Morgan Fuller just checked in the game for Frontier. Lobbed out to Dean, top of the key, right side to Portier. Portier driving right side, stopped. Back to Ella. Ella bounce pass to Olivia. Olivia Dean being guarded by Hannah Paul, trying to get someone to pass to. Tries to feed the paint, stolen back by Kenny. Tenney drives through, up off the glass, no good. And the foul is going to give Hannah Paul a couple of shots here. We'll see what they get.
Well, that was a good foul right there, honestly, by Olivia Dean. That was a really good foul right there.
Yep, it's on Olivia. So Hannah Paul will get two shots. Penn is only a junior. So that one more year here. Her shot does not go.
I'm starting to wonder if there's a lid on both of these baskets here, Chris. I think there's a lid going on here.
Well, you got to wonder. I mean,
wow.
It's unheard of for a team this talented to have 1 point this late in the second quarter. Second shot is no good. Putback is no good on the rebound. Another shot, no good. And they're able to keep it in, but blot it back in, but Walker is able to steal it back for Frontier. Dean now. Right side to Portier. Portier loses control and it gets fouled on the way through by Riley as Portier wound up on her knees after that hip check, and so Lisa will go to the line to shoot, I believe.
She will be getting, she'll be getting two. So, yep, we're in the double bonus here, Chris. And I'll tell you, these are very important free throws right here for them. You know, right now you're only up six.
Well, they can go up by it if she makes both of these. Portier's first one, good.
Oh, there's her first free throw of the night.
That's the second foul on Kiana Riley, as Bob said, the 10th team foul, which means we're shooting two the rest of this half for Frontier. Portier's second one is no good. Rebound controlled by Mahar. This is Tenney running up the right side. Tenney on the right elbow. Makes it back to Hannah Paul. Paul shoots for three and hits. It's a big three for them.
Oh, nice shot right there.
That cuts the Frontier lead to four. 2:13 to go in the half.
Hannah Paul picking up a huge basket that her team needed.
Now a little front court pressure. And Dean lobs it ahead. They break the press. Up ahead to Walker. Back to Portier. Right side to Ella. Ella runs on the right elbow. Jumper on the baseline. Does not go. Rebound Portier. Put back off the glass. No good. And the rebound pulled down by Mahar. Tenney brings it up. Right side to Vautour. Vautour feeds the paint to Powell, who gets fouled on the way up.
Well, that was a nice look inside for Mahar. Very good look inside. Now you got Maeve Powell. She's back at the line to shoot a couple.
Mahar is very fortunate that that Frontier did not really do a great job of shooting in that second quarter. Otherwise, this would be a much different game. First shot by Powell is good. She'll get one more, and this will cut this lead if she makes this one to two. Powell's second one, hard off the glass, no good. But put back on the rebound by Tenney is no good. And Frontier clears the boards. This is Dean now. Ella, left side to Walker. Back to Ella. Right side to Lisa Portier. Portier draws a screen, tries to go through it. Collides with Powell, no call. And Mahar gets it back.
That was good defense right there by Powell. She did a great job shutting off that lane.
Just stood her ground. Now Powell gets a pass from Paul in the paint. Loses control. Ball hits the floor. And the possession arrow will favor Frontier.
Well, if I'm Frontier right now, Chris, I'm going to use the clock and I'm going to be smart on my possessions, because if you can do two for one here, you got to take advantage of the two for one.
Yep. Inbound to Dean. And once again, that trap in place for Mahari. Lobs it ahead to Walker. They break it. And Portier was not over the line when she got that pass. And they're going to call it over and back. That's a tough break.
Oh, man. You just lost one of your possessions right there.
Well, that was a good call. She was still in the backcourt when she jumped to catch that pass. So John Patala was right there with the call.
Yep. Because what people don't understand, it's if your feet are not both on the other side of the court, then, you know, even if you're in the air, that doesn't matter.
Paul goes left side to Tenney. Right side to Vitor. Vitor's shot is no good. Porter, you're battling for the rebound. Ball's on the floor. Tie-up, possession arrow favors Mahar.
Hey, that's a great defensive play right there by number 13, Victoria Tenney. She did a nice job getting in there to be able to get that tie-up.
Samantha Rhoda inbound for the Senators. They have 15 on the shot clock, 46 on the game clock. Out to Powell. Now turnaround jumper by Rowe is no good. And ball knocked loose, knocked around. Mahar still controls it, and they get back. Oh, nice play by Portier on a poke pass. Portier.
Oh, and she got wailed going through.
A really hard foul. Never got the shot off, but she'll get two shots.
Whew. Well, we definitely know who the foul's on. It's definitely on Victoria Tenney. That's a guarantee. And honestly, that was a good foul.
Well,
seriously, that was a good foul. She had the open lane, bud.
It looked more violent than I think it probably was.
No, make her earn it now. That's all.
Porter at the line. First shot is good. That makes the lead 4. 20-16, 33.4 seconds to go in the half. Our halftime report is coming up. We'll talk about this one and talk about tomorrow night's season finale, regular season finale, in Buckland. Porter, your second shot. Front of the iron, no good. Rebound pulled down by Mahar. This is Jasmine Vitor. Runs through, shot up, no good. Porter,
now,
the rebound.
Now you take the last shot, Chris. Now you take the last shot. Now you got to listen to your coach.
Shot clock is off. Porter with the ball right side. Back to Dean. Dean over to Walker. Walker back to Ella. 12 seconds to Portier. Portier bounce pass to Ella Dean. Dean to Walker. 5 seconds to shoot. And they get the shot off. Side of the iron, no good. And that's how the half will end. Not a great exchange to end, but a pretty good second quarter by the Frontier Redhawks as they take a 20-16 lead into the break. We played one half of basketball from South Deerfield. Second half upcoming. Halftime report is next. This is high school basketball on Bear Country 95.3. We are at halftime from Goodnow Gymnasium in South Deerfield. At the half, the Frontier Redhawks lead the Mahar Senators by a count of 20-16. Mahar led 11-10 to end the first quarter, and then Frontier outscored them 10-5 to take a 4-point lead into the locker room. And a pretty impressive second quarter by the Redhawks.
Well, I think their defense was good, and I also think that they finally were able to start making a few shots. But the thing that still is bothering me is the fact that they missed probably 3 or 4 real easy buckets, Chris, that they should have had. And a couple of them were layups, and those are tough. But also, they're not doing so great from the free throw line either tonight, Frontier. They've missed a lot of shots.
Yeah, they haven't. That has happened other times before this season. They've had moments where the shooting has just really been very, very quiet and not great. But I got to love the way they played defense and the way they were handling Mahar, especially on the boards.
Well, they did a great job because in that first quarter, it was all about the offensive rebounding for Mahar, and they made that adjustment, and they were able to take that away. Then they started to attack the basket, which is very important, and by doing that, they got a lot of folks in Mahar's territory. They got a lot of folks from Mahar that are now in foul trouble because of it, because they did a nice job attacking the basket. You're going to have to stick to that same game plan that you had in the second quarter here in the second half, because I'll tell you right now, this Mahar team, they're not going to score 5 in the third quarter. They're going to come out a little bit more intense, and they're going to be ready to go. I tell you right now.
I was very surprised by the fact they only put up 5 points in that second quarter, especially given, you know, the amount of scoring they've done this season. I mean, they've been able to put up points in bunches, and it just didn't happen. But give Frontier credit. The defense, I think, made their lives a lot more difficult. And certainly I like the aggressiveness that Frontier has displayed. But we'll see if Mahar wakes up in the second half and comes out storming.
Well, I'll tell you right now, if I'm Frontier, I'm going to continue to do exactly what I did. I'm going to attack that basket and keep getting as many people in foul trouble as possible. But the key to that is, if you're going to do that, you got to make the freebies. And hopefully they can do better from the line if that's what they do in the second half.
Second half action upcoming momentarily. We are at the half. And on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, Frontier leads Mahar 20-16. This is high school basketball in Bear Country 95.3. Here. If you want to watch this game, it'll be available at the FCAT Media YouTube page in a couple of days, so you can see what you saw, what you're hearing.
which right now is a pretty good performance by both teams, and the Frontier Redhawks appear to have the advantage. Let's check out the scoring from the first half, Bob.
All right, why don't we start off with Mahar. Kenzie Tenney has 5, Hannah Paul with 4. Cassie, I'm going to tell you right now, this is a person who really, really got it going for them in the first quarter and went quiet. But Cassie Verhaen, she ended up having a really good first quarter, and then she went quiet. She has 6, and Maeve Powell has 1. So really only 4 scorers for Mahar. Now, what about Frontier? Same thing, 4 scorers. Hot Hand, Ella Dean with 9. Lisa Portier with 6. Diaz with 3, and Boyden with 2. So that's where we stand right now. Right now, we are in a very light scoring game of something I wasn't expecting. I was expecting this to be a lot higher score than what we had in the first half.
Yeah, I mean, I'm surprised too. And I think a low scoring game favors Frontier with that defense. I mean, if they can contain Mahar, keep them off the board, and put some more of these relatively easy shots in, they got a real good shot at winning this game and going again to 9-10 and 6-2 in the league. They're guaranteed, by the way, a tournament spot because they've locked up second place in the division. Mahar has locked up first place. So no matter what happens tonight, that's not going to change. These teams are both going into the postseason. Likely Mahar will probably, I would think, be hosting a game and Frontier probably going on the road. But postseason, anything can happen, and that's the great thing about March Madness is it can be one and done. They can be the best team in the league and have an off night and be out.
That's it. And I'm going to tell you right now that Cassie Verhaen, she ended up being a very big presence in that first quarter, and she went quiet. But you know what hurt her? She got herself into foul trouble.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what happened also with Kenzie Tenney. Kenzie Tenney also has had a really good half, but now she's in foul trouble with 3 fouls. So we'll have to see if Coach Fisher is going to bring her off the bench or if he's going to sort of hang on. I personally think that, hey, you got to go with it. You got to go with everybody right now. Yeah. And if she gets her 4th, then you can make that decision.
Of course, tomorrow night we wrap up the regular season. Hard to believe, but our final regular season broadcast tomorrow in Buckland as the Mohawk Warriors host the Turner's Falls Boys. And that game will start 6:45 pregame, 7 o'clock tip-off from Buckland.
Well, you know, I think right now you got 2 teams that honestly aren't really playing that well.
Right.
Turner's is not really playing that well, and Mohawk isn't really playing that well either. And we'll have to see what happens with Turner's. They need the victory, though. They need to be able to start getting some kind of spark so that they can get themselves ready for tournament. They're looking at definitely going on the road for their first tournament game. But when they started off the season 7-0, I had a different feeling about that, Chris, to be quite honest with you.
We're ready to start the second half. Frontier will inbound in front of us. Branna Walker to throw it in to Ella Dean to start the third frame. Frontier now moving right to left. Dean looking to feed on the baseline Diamond. Now Diamond gets it back from Diaz, back to Walker, top of the key, right side to Ella. Dean feeds Diaz in the paint. Diaz hook shot, no good, over everything. Portier crashes for the rebound but stepped on the baseline.
That was good defense right there by Verhaen. She did a nice job at being able to get Portier to get off balance and get the out-of-bounds call.
Hannah Paul now, left side to Riley. Back to Paul, top of the key, back over to Riley. Riley will spot up from 3, good. Ooh,
big shot right there by Kiana Riley. Her first points of the night.
And just like that, the lead is cut to 1. 2019, Frontier with the lead. Left side to Portier on the elbow. Portier feeds a breaking Diamond. Diamond put up shot, air ball, and a battle for the rebound and a foul.
And it looks like they're going to go with Kiana Riley, who just made the 3-pointer with the foul.
Yep, and that's 3 on Riley. Diaz now to shoot. First one does not go.
And the woes of the free throw line continue.
Oh, you got to start making these
for the Redhawks. Yeah, these are important. You got it.
And how many games have we seen in our time doing this that came down to free throws? Yeah, second shot, and that one goes. So it gets 1 of 2. 21-19. Now Paul brings the ball up, crosses half court, left side to Riley. Riley takes another 3. No good this time. Rebound and a putback by Powell is no good. And a hook shot putback by Verhaen is good.
See, I'm telling you, Verhaen is a very big part of this team right now, and they need her.
Tied at 21. Diamond on the baseline, shut off, tries to feed Diaz. Diaz gets the shot back up, no good. Verhaen the rebound.
Another missed layup, Chris.
Here come the Senators. Verhaen stops, right side to Riley. Riley drives to the elbow, back to Verhaen. Verhaen spins through, gets fouled on the way through as she got attempted stripped by Diamond. That's going to be on the floor, not shooting.
I tell you, Verhaen is definitely attacking the basket and doing a really nice job. She's definitely a weapon to this team right now, and they need her.
That's three fouls on Marie Diamond. She will step out, and Kate Hickey will come in. Inbound pass off of a Frontier player, so we'll start it all over again. Victoria Tenney to inbound for the Senators. Out to Paul. Paul driving on the right elbow. Hands it back to Riley. To Verhaen. Verhaen drives through, running. Hook shot off the glass is good.
Oh, nice move right there by Cassie. Big bucket right there. She's picked up two big buckets, including that big three by Riley. All of a sudden now, Mahar back into the swing of things.
Diaz gets a pass and is fouled on the way through as she throws to the basket. Well, if Verhaen starts to heat up like we know she can, it could be a very, very quick night. Diaz will go to the line for two shots. That's three fouls, actually two fouls on Maeve Powell. Elena's first one, no good.
Ah, another missed free throw.
These Frontier ladies will have senior night tomorrow night when the Ware Indians come to town to wrap up the regular season. Diaz, her second shot is good. Makes one of two. 23-22, 6:09 to go, third quarter. Anna Paul now, top of the key. Left side. And now it goes back to Verhaen. Verhaen drives through, off balance, and put it up and in.
Oh, they got to stop her. She is going to be the weapon that could be the difference in this one for Mahar.
Well, she's got three buckets here in the third quarter. Portier now, jumper from the corner is good. Inside the arc for two. Timeout on the floor. We will take the break. 5:44 to go in the third quarter. And on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, the Mahar Senators 25 and the Frontier Redhawks 24. This is high school basketball in Bear Country 95.3. Well, it appears the sleeping giant for the Mahar Senators, known as Cassie Verhaen, has woken up, Bob. She's sure. Got three buckets in this quarter, and right now her team has a one-point lead.
Well, you know, she's the offense right now for their team, and she's the one who's making the shots, but she's also attacking the basket and playing good defense, too. She's definitely right now one of our containers for our player of the game. She's definitely proven herself, and she is a person that they need on the court. As long as she can stay out of foul trouble, they're going to keep her in as much as possible.
Mahar inbound. Hannah Paul now runs the ball up for the floor. The running the point for the Senators. Left side to Riley. Riley gets the pass back. She jumps up for three. Back of the iron, no good. Portier gets the rebound for Frontier. A good job boxing out Maeve Powell there.
That was a really good box out right there by Portier.
Dean now, top of the key. Ella left side to Portier. Portier to Diaz. Diaz hook shot in the lane. Does not go. Spun out.
Good look. Good
she's,
look.
She's snake bitten right now. Tenney. Strong off the glass. No good. Rebound pulled down by Walker. And Ariana Walker to Dean. Between the circles. Ella. Left side to Portier. Excuse me. That's Hickey. Back over to Dean. Right side. Dean drives to the elbow. Three-pointer, way off, no good. And Mahar is able to contain.
Too bad, because that was a nice pick by Diaz.
Verhaen trying to drive through, loses control, gets fouled on the way through. As you're absolutely right, Bob, Verhaen's just going to go at the basket. She's going to just go straight ahead and draw as many fouls as possible, and that's three now on Helena Diaz.
Yeah, she's taking over this game right now, Chris. She really is. Out of all the players right now, she is taking over the game, and Portier is doing a nice job, too. If we can get Portier to be able to continue to find a way to get those easy layups, because she's had some good looks.
Diaz out with a three fouls. Lexa Boyden in the game for Frontier. Now Tenney now in the corner. Three ball from the elbow is no good. And the rebound pulled down by Kate Hickey.
All right, another one and done. That's good for Frontier to be able to get those.
Hickey to Dean, left side to Walker. Walker to Dean. Dean drives, stops. Bounce pass to Portier, drives it off her foot. Gets it back out to Ella. Ella for three.
Good! Big shot right there by Ella Dean. She's done a nice job from outside, getting some nice looks. Really good look right there, Chris.
Frontier now has the lead back, 27-25, 4:03 to go third. Now driving on the baseline, laying it up and in with Verhaen again.
She is on fire, Chris, and she's just going to continue to attack that basket.
Until they stop her, she will absolutely do that. Dean now, left side to Walker. Walker feeds the paint to Hickey, back to Walker, right side to Ella. 17 to shoot. Ella, right side, in the middle of to Hickey, left side to Portier. Now Dean to Hickey. Hickey to Portier in the lane, and she gets smacked by Verhaen going up for the shot. Hard collision.
Yeah, but that might be her fourth foul. I got to see the third, three or four.
I think that's three.
It is three. You're right.
Yeah, I thought she had only two, but that's three. So.
Okay. Boy, that was a hard foul, too.
They may have to get her out of there at this point.
I wouldn't.
Portier at the lane, the line, rather, to shoot two. First shot is good. Tonight's game being brought to you in part by Wigan Hydro Seed Landscaping, Gendon Auto Parts, and Quabbin Valley Auction. And she's staying out there. Row in. And Maeve Powell out for the Mahar Senators.
Yeah, you can't take out your hottest player with only three fouls. You got to keep on trucking, as they say.
Portier's second one. Front of the iron, no good. And the rebound by Munier is no good. And now Boyden, turnaround hook shot. The lane doesn't go. Boyden stays with it. And finally, it's stolen back by Mahar, by Tenney. Mackenzie Tenney running one-hander in the lane and a foul. It's going to be a blocking foul on Lisa Portier.
Wow, good hustle right there. Nice play by Kenzie Tenney. She's pulled down a lot of bounds tonight, Chris.
Well, it seemed like she was, at this point, she was saying, I'm getting sick of watching these second shots go up. I'm just going to take matters into my own hands. And her first shot is good. She will get one more.
She has one of those weird throws where it's just more sort of like a straight shot.
And the second shot is good.
Much makes better arc, yeah. Good job. Nice free throws right there.
And that gives Mahar the lead back, 29-28. We've had three or four lead changes in this third quarter. 3:12 to go. Dean left side to Portier. Portier goes cross court, gets a lane, lays it up, doesn't go.
Oh, man, another missed opportunity after a great play.
Tenney, bounce pass down the lane on the baseline to Riley, lays it up and in.
Nice give right there to Riley. Nice, easy two. And Mahar is now up by three.
Portier now. Dean, top of the key. Left side it goes to Olivia Dean. Olivia just stolen away, just took it right away from her to Verhaen. Verhaen goes up strong off the glass, too strong. Boyden the rebound. They're coming back the other way. Munier hands off to Portier, to Ella Dean. Left side to Lisa. Lisa bounce pass to Munier, high post and a foul. And we're going back the other way.
Well, they ended up traveling before the foul.
Okay.
Yeah, but I'll tell you right now, if that was a foul, that would have been on Verhaen.
Yep, 11-4.
You got it.
Good break from Mahar.
Yeah, big break.
Paul now. Right side to Verhaen. Verhaen goes up strong. Hook shot is good.
She's
good,
man.
And Mahar is going to take time out as suddenly they have a 5-point lead. 2:15 to go in the third quarter. On the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, it's Mahar 33, Frontier 28. This is high school basketball in Bear Country 95.3. So just like that, the Mahar Senators, and this has been about a 5 and 6 point swing throughout this game, have come back and taken the lead 33-28, largely on the play of Cassie Verhaen.
Yeah, she's the one that they need to stop right now. And I'll tell you, Riley's done a nice job, too. She was really quiet in the first half, but, boy, she's starting to step up her game. So really nice job by Riley. Great job by Verhaen. She's really been the force that they need right now and the big boost that Mahar's been able to get. Now, on the other side, the things that's really hurting Frontier right now are making free throws. And let's be honest, Chris, they've missed a lot of easy layups as well.
Absolutely. They got to start making those because they cannot afford to give away points to these guys. Inbound pass stolen by Mahar as they were well guarded. Verhaen now with the top of the key, left side to Paul. Paul for three, no. But the rebound put back is good again by Keanu Riley.
Wow, Riley really stepping it up here in the third quarter, Chris.
That trap is causing problems for Frontier right now. Both the Deans sprint out. They're trying to get the pass, and they get it to Ella. Ella surrounded by blue shirts, and they're stolen again. Verhaen steals the errant pass, goes strong through, running hook shot, no good, but she draws the foul.
And there you go. She attacking the basket, picks up another two free throws, and another foul. And a timeout again, Chris.
Frontier is going to keep take the timeout. We're going to keep it here, I think, with 1:47 to go in the third quarter. The big difference, though, is obviously, Bob, Mahar not playing nearly as tentatively as they did in that second quarter, and you can tell. It's just a whole different team.
I told you they were going to make those adjustments, Chris, and that's exactly what they did. And I got to give Coach Fisher a lot of credit where credit's due, and that is the fact that he's been able to sort of get that trap going, which has really been a pesky thing right now that Frontier's having trouble with. They're not being able to get the ball across the court. They're getting a little flustered, and let's just be honest here. Right now, Mahar really starting to play attack basketball. Instead of shooting those threes, they're starting to attack the basket, and they're getting the easier shots, and that's why they're starting to put some points back on the board.
Well, when you talk about adjustments, that's the biggest adjustment, is they're actually attacking the basketball, and they're playing their game. And I think that in the second quarter, they got sucked into to the Frontiers game a little bit, and the last thing you want to do is get away from what you do well and fall into the trap of playing the other team's style. So that's I think, the biggest adjustment. But you know, the emergence of Verhaen and Riley have really turn this game around, and Frontier's got to have an answer soon.
Yeah, and they've done a wonderful job. And right now, Cassie's going back to the line, and she's going to have an opportunity at a couple more free throws to add to their lead.
That was the third foul, by the way, on Lexa Boyden. So she and Diaz both have three, and they're the two big women for Frontier. Verhaen's first shot does not go. She'll get one more. Tonight's game being brought to you by CNA Repair and Equipment, electrician Neil A. Zielinski, and Deerfield Pharmacy. Verhaen's second. Does not go. He misses them both. Boyden the rebound. Missed opportunity there. And now Dean facing three defenders. Someone's got to come help her. She bounces it up ahead, gets it back. Now she gets over to Walker, and they're having a tough time getting it out. They finally cross with 13 seconds left on the shot clock. Dean, left side. Inside pass to Boyden. Boyden kicks it back out to Portier. Jumper, front of the iron, no good. Verhaen the rebound. Outlet pass to Paul. Paul drives through, lays it up, and it does not go.
Oh, man, another missed opportunity, but this time it was Maher with the missed opportunity.
Dean lobs it up ahead to Munier, and they'll finally set up a half-court offense. Dean, bounce pass left side to Walker. Back to Ella. Right side to Portier. Portier to Dean. Dean fakes the three. Goes left side to Walker. Walker inside to Boyden. Boyden dishes to Munier off the glass. Too strong. Mahar with the rebound. This is Tenney. Left side to Paul. Paul. Right side to Riley. Three. Side of the iron. No good. 40 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Dean gets the outlet pass. 27 seconds on the shot clock. 33 on the game clock. Dean crosses half court. Left side to Walker. Walker to Ella. Right side to Portier. Portier drives through to Munier. Back out to Walker. Jumper. Banks it in.
Ah, oh, big shot right there by Walker. She needs to start taking an opportunity at taking a few shots. She sort of scares you when you get down to 2 seconds left and the entry passes.
8 seconds left. Mahar with the ball. They throw it away. So Frontier coming back the other way with 2.8 seconds left.
Here's where you set up a couple of screens, Chris. Try to see if you can get a shot off at least at half court.
You got to go the length. Portier inbounding. Looking for someone to throw to. She does to Walker. And they're not going to get a shot off. And that will be how the third quarter will end. We have played three from Goodnow Gymnasium in South Deerfield on the Grieving Savings Bank scoreboard. It is Mahar now, 35, and Frontier, 30. High school basketball in Bear Country 95.3. Fourth quarter upcoming, and we ended the first half with a 4-point Frontier lead. We start the fourth quarter with a 5-point Mahar lead. So
well,
the swings have been amazing in this game.
Well, you know what the big difference is 19 points in that quarter was scored by Mahar, which is something that they've been missing, and they were missing in the first half was scoring. So, but the thing is, they shot a lot of threes in the first half, Chris. They did not take as many threes in the third quarter, and it surely paid off. And what about Cassie Verhaen? She's having a great, great night.
Making a bid for Helena Chemical Player of the Game. She has the ball now on the right elbow to start the fourth quarter. She drives through. Hook shot in the lane. Oh, almost went. Didn't go, though.
Battle for the rebound, and it's going to go back the other way as it went off of a Mahar player. But Verhey not at all afraid to throw that hook in the lane.
No, she's a player, man. I like watching her game. Great D.
Impound pass stolen by Tenney. Puts it up and in.
Ah, that's how you take defense and turn it into offense. Great job right there by Victoria Tenney.
Yeah, Mahar's defense has been great in this half. A pass to Dean goes through her hands. Right now, Frontier is unraveling a bit as Mahar has really stepped it up.
Yep. They really have changed their whole game plan from the first half to this one. Has been a totally different team that we saw.
Inbound pass to Paul. Over to Tenney. Three-pointer, no good. Put back off the glass. Doesn't go by Tenney. That was Mac Tenney off of Victoria Tenney. And the rebound knocked off of a Mahar player, so Frontier will get it back in front of the Mahar bench.
They're having trouble right now. You got to get somebody who's going to be able to get the ball up the court. Set a pick.
Diamond inbound for the Senators. Drops it back to Dean in the backcourt. Ellen now will drive up. Up ahead to Walker. Back to Dean. Right side to Diamond. Back to Ella. Top of the key. And the pass intended for Diamond is stolen by Hannah Paul. Hannah goes up, lays it up and in.
Oh, good defense right there by Mahar. They have really stepped it up here.
Largest
in
lead
the
of the
second
game.
Half. 30, absolutely.
39-30. Largest lead of the game for either team. As that trap is really causing problems. And there's another steal by Mahar off of that trap. Wow. And Verhey goes up strong and draws the foul.
Wow, they've really taken over.
Yeah, this game, it was starting to go Mahar's way in the third. Now it's all Mahar at this point. And Marty Sanderson wants to talk about it. We will take the break. 6:51 to go in the game, and the Senators are smelling blood in the water. They lead Frontier 39-30 on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. This is high school basketball on Bear Country 95.3. 9:30 on the scoreboard. Mahar all in control of the game right now as their defense has led to a 4-0 run here in this start of this fourth quarter.
Well, really nice job right there by Mahar being able to make the adjustments that they need to make to be able to take control of this game, and that's exactly what they've done. But the one person who has really taken control of this game and has definitely proven that she is leading the way for her team is Cassie Verhey. She has done a great job tonight. Like her game.
She can make this a double-digit lead for the first time for Mahar in this game. First shot is good. She will get one more and makes it 40-30. Second shot is good. Makes them both.
Yeah, she's having a night, Chris. No doubt about it.
41-30. Less than seven to go. They're trying to get the ball in. They do. Diamond's out there with four fouls, bounces it up ahead. It gets tipped by Mahar. They can't even get the ball out of the backcourt right now.
They can't.
That is how strong the Mahar trap has been. Diamond throws it into Dean in the backcourt. She gets a little bit of daylight up ahead to Walker. Walker back to Ella between the circles. Right side to Diamond. Back to Dean. Dean spots up for three. Good.
Oh, big shot right there. Ella Dean, that was a huge shot that they needed right now for Frontier. Now you got to play some defense, Chris. You got to start getting a couple of possessions to go your way.
Verhey drives through the lane, dishes it on the baseline. Shot up, no good. Rebound controlled by Diamond of Frontier. Portier now runs it up the right side. Up ahead to Diamond. Diamond cross courts Dean. Dean crosses half court. Ella to Diamond, back to Dean. Bounce pass left side to Walker. To Portier, off the glass, no good.
Oh boy, Lisa Portier's missed so many easy buckets. But you know what? I want to give credit where credit's due, Chris. You know, the one thing that I've been impressed with is Ariana Walker has given her really nice entry passes, Chris.
Yeah, she really has. Walker's played very, very well. I think that there have been a lot of good individual performances. But right now, Mahar is playing a better team game in the second half. Riley to Paul, right side to Tenney. It's Victoria to McKenzie. And
offensive foul
on Mac Tenney.
Yep, and I think that's her third or fourth. Might be her fourth.
See what they post. It's her fourth, you're right. Diamond playing with four fouls inbound. She does to Dean. Back to Diamond, back to Ella. Ella is able to get by the defender. Runs it up into Mahar territory. A little kick on Verhey. This will be a reset of the 30. So Frontier will inbound in front of their own bench with a fresh 30 and 5:41 to go on the game clock.
Mahar is not letting up on the D at all. They're just going after these players. Right now, though, now's your chance to take a break. Now you're already in this half court. Just play some good defense.
Boyden and Muni are back in. Diaz and Porter are out for Frontier. Dean, left side to Walker. Walker tries to feed Munier down low, but it's stolen back by Verhaen, who's been everywhere in this half. Verhaen, it's stripped on the way up, though. Nice play by Diamond. And gets back to Ella Dean.
Well, now I know why Coach Marty Sanderson has kept Marie in the game, is because she has done a great job on defense. Ooh.
Foul is going to be on Hannah Paul, blocking foul. And it's going to be a possession, I believe, and we're not near the bonus yet. It's only two on Hannah.
Nearly not as many fouls as we had in the first half, Chris, at all.
Dean gets the inbound pass, top of the key. Left side to Ariana Walker. To Diamond, left elbow. Diamond, back to Dean. Dean, left side to Diamond. Diamond for three.
Good!
Big shot right there by Diamond. That is huge. Between that and the three from Ella Dean, all of a sudden now it's a five-point game.
Verhaen drives the baseline, too strong, out of bounds. It's going to stay with Mahar.
Well, now you just step up your defense now, Chris. Now you got to get one and done. That's what you got to do, one and done.
Absolutely have to lock them down if you can. Mahar is able to inbound, top of the key, left side to Verhaen. Verhaen drives the baseline, and blocking foul going to be on Boyden, and that might be four on her.
I think it is. I think that's her fourth. So,
well, they gave it to Munier. That's a break for Frontier.
Hey, there you go.
I was absolutely sure it was on Boyden, but it's on Munier.
Oh, she's been hot at the line. Here we go.
Varian's first is good.
She is a player.
Tonight's game being brought to you in part by Andy's and the Oak Shop and Helena Chemical Company, sponsor of the Helena Chemical Player of the Game. Second shot is good. Makes them both.
Solid. Solid.
7-point lead for Mahar. 4:44 to go in the game. They're trying to inbound. Diamond and Dean trying to break the trap. They do. They throw it up heavy. They throw it away.
Wow. You got to move. You know what the problem is with Frontier right now is they're not moving. When you got somebody, if there's three people on you, that means that there's somebody open.
A lot of people open, and they have not responded well to that trap in the second half. Left side to Riley. Kiana. To Verhaen, hook shot over everything. Rebound pulled down by Victoria Tenney. Victoria, three from the corner, hits the side of the iron, no good. Deep rebound goes to Verhaen. Ends up in the hands of Riley, three ball, no good.
Oh boy.
Victoria Tenney rebound. Hannah Paul for three. Bank shot, no good. Finally a rebound and an over the back foul by Kiana Riley.
Well, they got four opportunities on that one possession, and they came up empty, so that was a big break right there for Frontier, but they got to continue to find a way to get the ball back on their side of the court.
That's the fourth foul, by the way, on Keanu Riley. Quick break, timeout. 4:08 to go in the game on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. It is Mahar 43 and Frontier 36. 4:08 to go in the game, and Mahar holding on to this 7-point lead, but it's tenuous at best right now, the way Frontier is starting to come back.
Well, you know, what's happening right now is they came up with a couple of big threes, which are great, but, you know, when you give another team that's really good four extra shots and they still come up empty, that's a break for your team. So right now, Frontier's got to find a way to break the press, and they got to get back on their end, and they got to set something up. They need a basket right now. There's only 4 minutes and 8 seconds left in the game here.
Diamond to throw in, again, against the trap. Dean loses control of it temporarily. Pass to Walker, back over to Dean. And they're having a tough time even getting it across the half court. Now, that's going to be five on Riley as a reach-in foul is called. She's out of the game.
Wow.
Ooh. Mahar fans don't like it, but Kiana Riley is done. And this is going to be a 1-1 at the other end.
Yeah, that was a tough break right there for her, but she had a really fine game for her team, and especially in the third quarter, coming up with those big 7 points. So a tough one there for Riley, and she ends up fouling out of the game.
They have 30 seconds to replace her. And that takes away a big three-point threat, too, from Mahar, because she's been real solid in the second half, shooting from the outside. So Victoria Tenney will come in. to replace her. Lexa Boyden will shoot a 1-1 on the other end as Mahar is into the bonus. This is where the foul shots become very important, Bob. Second shot. First shot is no good. And Verhaen the rebound. Loses control but gets back up. And Cassie Verhaen goes left side to Tenney. Victoria now to Paul. On left side and a reach-in foul.
And that's it for Diamond.
If that is on Marie, she's done. Verhaen will go to the line for a 1-1. Portier in, Diaz in.
And Diamond's definitely
and Diamond's out. I don't know if Marty knows that, but
he does now because he's putting in Victoria Dean.
Yep. So Olivia, Ella, both the Deans out there, and we've got Diaz, Portier, and Walker, the five on the floor for the Red Hawks. Verhaen's first shot is good. She'll get one more.
Boy, she is having a night. Fantastic night.
That makes the lead eight. She's been burying these free throws when she's needed to.
Sure has.
Second shot does not go. And a whammy there. And the rebound controlled by Frontier. Walker to Portier. And again, three defenders in their face. And they knock the ball loose. Paul gets it back from Mahar. That trap has been unbelievable. But Paul double dribbled, so a break for Frontier.
You know, that was a really good call right there by Patala because she did double dribble. And most people wouldn't have saw that with four people there, but she did a nice job. He did a nice job making that call. Now they got to find a way. The trap is just unbelievable.
And there's a steal off the trap of a bad pass. And Mahar gets it back. Jumper in the lane, no good. Paul the rebound. And it goes back out to Bator. And Mackenzie Tenney feeds Verhaen in the paint off the glass, too strong. Tenney put back no good, but she'll go to the line.
Another four offensive rebounds for Mahar. Boy, I got to tell you right now, Frontier looks very tired.
They do. They look like they're out of gas, and it just every single indication is that Mahar is just on top of their game. They're finishing strong. First shot, no good. One more upcoming. 3:05 to go in the game, 44-36. This will make it a 9-point lead if she makes this one. And that doesn't go either. But a rebound put back up and in by Victoria Tenney to clean up.
Well, you figure that let's have one Tenney pick up the other Tenney.
Well, right now, the lead is Tenney. It's 46-36, and then another steal on an inbound pass. It seems like every inbound pass that comes in is being stolen by Mahar. Now foul.
Wow.
And Verhaen will go back to the line.
That's the one person you don't want at the line right now. She is making everything.
And Diaz is going to come out with four fouls. And so is Portier. Trading offense for defense. And Boyden is back in and Munier is back in. Cassie Verhaen's first shot is good. She will get one more. This will make it a 12-point lead. And Frontier is running out of opportunities to come back. Verhaen's second shot is good. Makes them both.
Nothing but nylon.
48-36. 2:48 to go in the game. Dean trying to get it in. An inbound pass. She falls down. Gets it back. Olivia now. Back to Ella and a reach-in foul on... No, what do they say?
They called it a travel.
Oh. It's really coming... wheels are coming off the wagon right now for Red Hawk Nation in this fourth quarter. Mahar has just come back and has the boot on the proverbial throat. In the corner it goes. Now back over to Mack Tenney. Now a three-pointer by Powell is no good. Putback is no good on the rebound. Another putback by Mack Tenney, and she'll go to the line.
Wow. Another series of offensive rebounds. Exactly what happened in the first quarter. All of a sudden in the third and fourth quarters, after doing such a great job Frontier in the second quarter, it's all happened again.
Yeah, and I don't think we've been out of this end of the floor in probably 3 minutes. Something like that. It's four fouls on Lexa Boyden, by the way.
And Tenney is still continuing to struggle from the free throw line.
She got that one, though.
There you go.
One of two. That makes it a 49-36 lead, 13-point lead from Mahar, largest of the game for either team. Olivia's trying to throw it in. She does. But look at the swarming defense. There's four defenders. They finally break the press. Munier to Boyden, and they went. Just the pass was ahead of her.
Wow.
I mean, it's just not happening for Frontier. They are dying fast and quiet in this fourth quarter.
Yeah, and they're gassed. I mean, they're gassed out. You know, they're doing so much running trying to get open, Chris.
They have not let off the steam. And that trap has been just brutal. Verhaen drives the baseline, dishes it off for Powell. Shot no good. Olivia Dean the rebound to Ella. Up ahead to Walker to Boyden. And finally, an offensive set for Frontier. Walker to Dean. Right side. Olivia Dean for three. Front of the iron, no good. Verhaen the deep rebound. Minute 40 to go. Cassie Verhaen to Paul to Tenney. And a blocking foul on the baseline, and I believe that's the end of the night for Alexa Boyden if it's on her.
I think it is. Yep. She's heading to the bench.
Marty Sanderson's going to argue, but it's not going to work. Marty wants a clarification, and we'll take a 30-second break. 1:33 to go in the game. 49-36. Mahar leads on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard back in 30. So 1:33 to go in this one, and in this fourth quarter has really been the story. I mean, it was every one of these quarters told a different story, Bob. You know, you had the sort of the chess match in the first quarter. You had Frontier really come out strong in the second and take the game away, it seemed. The third quarter, Mahar climbed back in. Verhaen caught fire. And in the fourth quarter, it's been the trapping defense that has been the story. It's just really, really hard to even get the ball in for Frontier.
And I give a lot of credit to Coach Fisher, because Coach Fisher's saying, listen, you know, we got playoffs coming up, ladies. You got to start being able to get yourself ready for a tournament. And this is the kind of stuff that we're going to have to do to be able to win a couple of those games. And let's just do it tonight against our team that is going to the playoffs too. So,
and they have been doing it for real tonight. Maeve Powell at the line to shoot two. First shot does not go. She'll get one more.
She struggled from the line here tonight. Maeve has only made one shot out of six attempts.
She makes that one.
Yes, she does.
And that makes it a 14-point Mahar lead with a minute 33 to go in the game. Walker to Dean. Back to Walker. Back to Ella. Ellis, again, facing two defenders. Not a lot of help. Olivia now gets wrapped up. Possession arrow, tie-up favors Frontier, but you can almost see the frustration right now in the backcourt.
Well, the bottom line is why are you bringing the ball back? You got to bring it forward.
Right.
And when you have Porter, you're wide open. But Lisa's going to open her mouth and say, I'm open. Hello?
Ella bounces it ahead to Ariana Walker. Walker nearly travels and did. Yep. I was wondering if they were going to catch it, but it's pretty obvious.
It's funny because right after I said it, Lisa Portier goes, hey! I think everybody's hearing me out tonight.
Mackenzie Tenney is out of the game as Mahar brings it up for the final minute, 9:30 seconds on the shot clock. Bonk now goes left side to Jordan Martin, just checked in. Martin now. Top of the key to Bonk. Bonk in a high post. And it goes to Powell, and the attempt in the middle by Rowe is no good. A minute left, 25 seconds of the shot clock for Frontier. Mahar is going to get this win, and one that for a while there looked like it was unlikely. Quick shot by Olivia Dean's no good. Portier the deep rebound. Fresh 30. Portier tries to drive through, feeds Diaz in the paint, and it's stolen back by Maeve Powell, who runs it up the floor. Powell will stop. Right side to Vitor. To Martin, and back over to Vitor. 19 seconds left, shot clock is off. They can throw it around, and I don't know if they'll play for another shot or not, or they'll just dribble it out, but Rowe now, and they'll take another shot from the corner. Doesn't go. Ella Dean the rebound, and 5 seconds left, and that is how this game is going to end, aptly enough, with a steal by a Mahar point guard. That will do it for this contest, as the Mahar Senators basically take over the game. And I mean take over with a major statement in the fourth quarter. And they win by a count of 50-36 on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. The high school basketball postgame show is up next on Bear Country 95.3. Well, it was a tale of really four separate quarters in this game, Bob, but the fourth quarter was the one that was the operative one. That was when Mahar took this game over, and they walk away with a pretty convincing 50-36 win over the Frontier Redhawks.
Well, you know, it came down to two things. Came down to offensive rebounds, came down to stifling defense, and it also came down to scoring baskets. And that's exactly what Mahar did in the second half. Ended up scoring 34 points in the second half, where Frontier only ended up scoring 16, so you see the big difference, yeah, especially with Frontier going into the locker room with that four-point lead.
Yeah, they did. They took a 20-16 lead into the half, and you're thinking, well, I mean, if they can keep playing the way they've been playing, they weren't making a lot of the easier shots, but you're thinking if they play the same kind of defense and Mahar continues to be tentative, well, that ended quickly when Cassie Varian came out in the third quarter and started to just start piling up points. And then, but in the fourth quarter, it was the Mahar defense that really was the story. That Mahar trap really confused and made it very, very tough for Frontier and wore them down. And that's why you wind up. If you look in the box score tomorrow, you see a 14-point win. You're going to think, well, Mahar took it to him. But this was a much more even matchup, I think, than anybody expected. But Mahar comes away with a W, and they've proven why they're undefeated in the league.
They sure do. And another thing that needs to be complimented is how about those offensive rebounds that they were able to get. But not only that, but getting to the free throw line a lot.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what really was the difference in this game, if you want to be straight up, was there was an awful lot of free throw attempts that were made by each team, but Mahar made a lot more than Frontier did, unfortunately.
Absolutely.
On the night. And it really came down to that one girl, number 31, Cassie Verheyen, is fantastic, and very impressed with her game. Very impressed with her game.
Final numbers, then we'll say goodnight, and we'll reveal our Helena Chemical Player of the Game. Not much of a real mystery here, I don't think.
Well, let's just tell you that Ella Dean had a great night tonight from deep. She ends up with four threes on the night, ends up with 15 on the night for Frontier. Lisa Portier ends up with 9 on the night. Marie Diamond with 3. Ariana Walker with 2. And Alexa Boyden with 2. There's your 36 for Frontier. For Mahar, 23 points for Cassie Verheyen. She ends up leading the way for her team. With 8 is Mackenzie Tenney. I thought Kenzie Tenney had a nice game tonight. She also picked up a lot of rebounds, too. Kiana Riley comes up with a couple of big buckets in the third quarter, ends up with 7 on the night. Victoria Tenney with 4, and Maeve Powell with 2. There's your 50 for Mahar. Mahar walks away with the 14-point win and also a very impressive victory after being down by 4 at halftime.
With the win, Mahar goes to 14-5 overall, 7-0 in league play. The Frontier Redhawks dropped to 8-11 overall and 5-3, but doesn't matter because they've locked up second place, so they're going to the postseason. Both these teams are postseason bound, and we'll certainly follow their progress along with all the other teams, and we'll find out on Saturday where all your local teams are going to be seated going into the postseason here in local Western Mass High School basketball. So that'll do it for our broadcast, our next broadcast of high school basketball. Bob and I are in Buckland tomorrow night as the Turners Falls Indians and the Mohawk Warriors wrap up regular season play. And we'll be on the air with that 6:45 with the pregame and 7 o'clock with the tip-off from Buckland. That'll do it for our broadcast for tonight. Again, on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, the Mahar Senators defeat the Frontier Redhawks by a count of 50-36. From our broadcast partner, Bobby C., and studio producer, Dave Reno, I'm Chris Collins saying so long from South Deerfield on Bear Country 95.3.